Now on BBC Two, this is Dennis Hopper, upfront and candid. The Maverick speaks out.
Career of American actor, writer, director Dennis Hopper spans an amazing 5 decades. Amazing, not just because he has survived the rigors of the movie business for so long, but that he has survived, period. Hopper is the definitive Hollywood rebel. He's worked with such legendary directors as Henry Hathaway and Nick Rey, and acted with the likes of Marlon Brando, James Dean, John Wayne, and Jack Nicholson. He's also abused his mind and body with just about every chemical substance known to man. Moving Pictures presents a completely frank documentary about the outrageous life and times of Dennis Hopper. From his first television appearance to his LA gang movie, Colors, here are the binges and breakdowns, the blockbusters and box office disasters. This one-hour program made in America features Hopper himself, his family, and fellow filmmakers, Francis Ford Coppola, Roger Corman, and David Lynch. They'll be our guides on a white-knuckle ride into the mind of Hollywood's most dangerous man. Hold on tight.
I mean, he reached the point where he was insane. I mean, he reached the point, you know, I went to the hospital to visit him. I mean, say hello to him, and between hello, how are you, was maybe 10 minutes. He went, I mean, totally lost his cookies.
I remember calling Century City Hospital and talking to the doctors, and they were saying, you know, we really think he's practically brain dead.
Get your motor running. Head out on the highway. Looking for adventure. In whatever comes our way.
Easy Rider. It didn't really matter. I think that Peter and myself and Jack were in this film so much as the film was something that an audience would go to and see what they would like to think of themselves as a counterculture here. And the idea of people dropping out. Easy Rider showed a lot of things that people had not seen before. For example, smoking marijuana without going out and killing a bunch of nurses.
They think we're going to cut their throat or something there. I'm like, they're scared, man.
Oh, they're not scared of you. They're scared of what you represent to them.
Amen. All we represent to them, man, is somebody who needs a haircut.
Oh, no. What you represent to them is freedom.
What the hell's wrong with freedom, man? That's what it's all about.
Oh, yeah, that's right. That's
a candy-colored clown they call the Sandman tiptoes to my room every night just to sprinkle stardust and to whisper, go to sleep, everything is all right. I close my eyes.
Let's fuck! I'll fuck anything that moves!
Dennis is hooked into something that's very American in the coolest sort of way. He's sort of the perfect American dangerous hero. And I don't know quite how it all happened.
my early memories of, like, you know, Kansas or, like, sort of classical stuff. I was raised on sort of a small little farm, little rural area. There was a ditch in front of the house, a lot of weeds, very fertile place, Kansas, and dirt road in front, mailbox, you know, country road. I used to go up where the train went by, wondering where the trains were going. My grandmother used to fill her apron full of eggs, and I'd walk in, like, you know, 7 miles or whatever it was into town and sell the eggs at the poultry place and go to the matinees and see Roy Rogers and Gene Autry. And Wild Bill Elliott was my favorite because he wasn't a singing cowboy. In the summer, all the combines came from Oklahoma, you know. Trains of combines would go by. I'd lay in the ditch and watch it with my dog.
Grandmother read him every child's book in the Dodge City Library before he started kindergarten and was reading him novels. We didn't live where there were a lot of children, so he only knew children when he was at school. As a little tiny child, he didn't have anyone to play with.
Born to be wild. Born to be wild.
My grandfather had an old truck. Where the water usually is on a where you put the water in a radiator, that was the gas, where the gas went in. So I used to lay on the hood and take the lid off and sniff the gasoline. And then I'd lay back and I'd look up in the sky and I'd see clowns and I'd see all these fantasies of stuff in the clouds, you know, and like get very high. And then one time I flipped out, I don't remember this, but when I came to, I was breaking the, I was attacking this monster, which was the truck itself, with a baseball bat and breaking out the lights and the windshield and so on. And that was the end of my sniffing gasoline. And when I moved to San Diego, I told my parents that I wanted to take acting lessons. They were horrified at the idea, but I started taking classes. And then later started playing small parts at the Old Globe Theater in San Diego.
He was the only high school student that ever got to be in the Shakespeare Festival. They were all college students. He was 18. He had $200 and he went to Hollywood. We didn't want him to go. We said, when you run out of your $200, you come home or call us and we'll come get you. He had no car, nothing. Before Christmas, he did a medic show, and he came out smelling like a rose.
Ma'am, I thought I'd drop in a minute. I just talked to Dr. Moore. He says I'm pretty well. Doesn't think I'll have any more trouble. I keep thinking of a poem I read a long time ago, the last verse. It's called Stanzas to Augusta. He was very much in love with her, but it was hopeless because she was his sister.
Robert, what is it? What's the matter?
The next day, seven studios called and one put me under contract, possibility of going under contract. The first one was Columbia. I donned my tie and my suit, and I went with my agent to Columbia Pictures. Now, I'd never been in a studio, and it was all, like, really, really new. I was goo goo gaga. I was taken into a man's office named Harry Cohn. He also had a psychological ploy of a very long room with his desk at the end of this long room. And behind that desk were these rainbow effects of Academy Awards. By the time I got to this desk, this long walk there, I was sweating and I was, you know, I found a crack in the ceiling. I was really nervous. I, you know, I'd never seen Academy Award, much less been a, you know, it was all like really something.